That they encouraged me. They supported. When I wanted to play a piano, they bought me a little tiny piano. A guitar, they bought me a little guitar. We weren't a very rich family in Sydney. So, but they wanted me to do what I wanted. And the one thing I'll remember is they never, ever stopped me from dreaming or believing I could be bigger than what I was. Very important. I could be anybody. Fireman, astronaut, whatever I wanted to do, they encouraged. Never forced, always encouraged. Okay, let's get into the six letters. GPSPAB. GPSPAB. G. So what does G stand for? All right, G, some people say God, geometry. It's goal. And what's goal? It's a dream. And what's a dream? It's a destination. Okay, it's a destination. It is, you are going somewhere, you are achieving. So let's go back to the word G. Now, I'm gonna have to cut this a bit short, but if we went outside and we caught a taxi, went inside, put the meter on, and we told the driver absolutely nothing, what's gonna happen? Nothing. But the driver has already turned the meter on. He says, hey, where are you going? We just don't say anything. So he'll either do this, he'll stop, but the meter's running. Time ticking, money ticking. The second thing he'll do, he'll go around in circles. Because he doesn't know, he's waiting for you to say left, right, straight, stop. Time ticking, money ticking. And finally, he'll just go really, 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 really slowly. Again, money and time ticking away. Now for me, and I'm sure for all of you, we can all make money. But what about time? Once it's gone, zoop, that's it, it's gone. So time is invaluable. Now, what happens if we said to him, we want to go to Beijing? He's going to go, oh, no, no way, no way. Say, hey, we'll pay you double, we'll pay you triple. Okay. Now, what happens? We get in the car, we start driving. Of course, we get a flat tire, we might get into an accident, we might go the wrong way, we might go get lost. Now, it might take us one day, it might take us 1 week, it might take us 1 year, but where will we eventually end up? Beijing. We will get there, eventually, no matter what, because we have a destination. So, goal, dream, destination. G-P-S-P-A-B, G-P, so what's the P? What's the P, guys? Purpose, purpose. What is the reason we get up every day? What was the reason why I got into Miss Saigon? Of course it was my career, it was a job, I made my parents proud, I showed my friends, you see, I did it. Actually, one of my teachers, before I got into the show, said, you can't sing very well. You can't do, I wanted to do the third level of singing. He said, no. He said, you can't sing very well. You're not very good. He put me down. And when I got into Miss Saigon, the next year, I said, you know. So anyway, so G-P-S-P-A-B-P, purpose. What's the reason? Why do you want that Ferrari? Why do you want to become a billionaire? Why do you want to be a movie star? What's the purpose driving you every day to achieve your goal? G-P-S. All right, S and P, so the second P, G-P-S-P, S and P. I'm sure you're coming up with a lot of different words. So what's the S and P? I'll say it together, because they are together. Strategy and plan. Strategy and plan. Now a lot of people get that confused sometimes or not very clear. What's a strategy? What's a plan? So for me, a strategy is the big picture. It's the overall strategy, and the plan are the details. What am I doing today? What am I doing tomorrow? It's like a business plan where you have your SWOT analysis, right? Strengths, weakness, opportunities, threats. So the plan is very important, as well as the overall strategy. Now, I'm gonna give you a little bit of an experience. I came to Shanghai with a strategy 12 years ago. 12 years ago. And the strategy was to build a musical theatre industry. And when I came, nobody knew what a musical was. Very little. They thought it was an opera, thought it was drama. I said, no, it's a musical. That was my strategy. And we did a lot of different things to get there. And I tell you, I failed so many times. And I want to say to you today, failures are pillars to success. Do not be afraid to fail. Because if you don't know how to fail, you do not know how to succeed. So, strategy, plan, together. GPS, goals, purpose, strategy, plan. All right, what's the A? What's the A? Okay, GPS-P-A. I think I heard somebody say action. Action. Now, a lot of people get all the other letters right. GPS-P-A-P. They get the plan, they got the strategy, they got the goal, they got the purpose. Yes, I want to become a millionaire. But then the action. They stop at the point of doing. Or, as another speaker said, persisting on doing. Now, in 2000, I put together, you've all heard of the Beatles, I'm sure, the Beatles, very famous British band. I put together the Quarrymen. Now, what people don't know, the Beatles actually didn't start as the Beatles. They started as the Quarrymen. Now, the Quarrymen started with John Lennon, Paul McCartney. Then, a drummer left and Ringo Starr came in. And somebody else left, George Harrison. And then the Beatles was formed. Now, I brought that original band together in 2000 in London. I hired the whole Palace Theatre where Les Miserables was showing. That whole theatre was mine for one day. And we put together the show that commemorated John Lennon's death. We were the only ones in the whole of the UK to do it. To a point that BBC World News did a special on us. I had letters from the White House, from Julian Lennon. We were sued by Yoko Ono. Who said you can't use the word Lennon. It's one of the few names in the world that's actually copyrighted. So we changed 48 hours before the show, we had to change the name to All You Need Is. My point is a lot of people that say, how did you bring the Quarrymen to London? I said, I went on their website and I called them. That's it. I called them. It's like when you see a pretty girl and you want to get her number. You just have to go up and say, hi, my name's Robert. Can I have your number? I'm not afraid of rejection. I'm not afraid of failure. Action is the key to get you to that next step. So, where are we? GPS-P-A. So we've done the action. Now what's the B? What's the B? Because this B, to me, is what glues everything together. It's what brings it all together. B. Belief. Belief. Belief in oneself. Belief in what you're doing. Belief in what you're doing. Now that's sometimes that's really hard to do, right? Because everyone wants to cut you down. Everyone wants to tell you cannot do it. You're going to fail. But you have to believe beyond yourself. What you need to do is believe that what you are doing is greater than you as a single person. It's greater than you than a single person. Now what does that mean? It means, if I asked everybody here today for 1,000 kwai each, you're all going to look at me and go, yeah, whatever. Now if I said to you all, let's put all that money together, everyone puts in 1,000, and we're going to build a home in South America, a home in Africa, for the kids, for 1,000 kids to get education each year. Now suddenly, it's not me anymore, it's not Robert Vicencio. It's a greater cause. There's a greater belief in what we're doing together. Now, 2.5 years ago, three now, I created a show called Rock Scissors Paper. It was an original Chinese musical. It took us 2.5 years to make. During that time, Even my partner said, you won't make it. You will fail. One of my other investment guys said, yeah, you already failed, Robert. You've got to give the money back. And this was even before we opened. Persistence and the belief in yourself kept me going. And then what happened? We did the show. We did 8 shows. Great success. 5 days ago, so they do a report every year, the government, we see we were announced as the top 4 box office earning original musicals in China. 4 out of 4 of them, 2 of them were actually from Taiwan. And the other mainland original musical was Jay Cho. Jay Cho's written, and I said, wow, that's pretty cool. So, I guess the point there is this. I believed in myself and I persisted. I know everybody here today has a dream, I'm sure. And everybody has the challenges and the hurdles. And we all feel it's impossible sometimes to actually get to where we want to go. Is your dream as clear as it should be? Do you know exactly what you want to do? Is that dream so crystal clear? If you wanted to buy a car, I know what color it is. I know what the handlebar is going to feel like. What's the seat? Is it leather? Is it black? Is it cream? What does it feel like? The crystallization of a dream and the belief in that dream, I tell you, again and again, it becomes real. Now, when people ask me, have you achieved your dream, Robert? I'm sure you're asking me right now, have you achieved your dream? I say, yes, actually, I've achieved about 8 dreams. And I tell you, once you start to achieve one, the next one becomes easier. Once you get the flavor of achieving a dream, it becomes so much easier the next time. I've performed over 3,000 shows, as they told you. I've done Hollywood films. I've met all celebrities here and there, published my own book, did a boxing competition 2 years ago, which I won. I won't do boxing again, ever. That's what my mom said. But dreams is so important to have. And when I meet people and they say, I don't know what my dream is. I don't know. That's where we've got to change that mentality. So I'm going to leave you with a very simple saying by George Bernard Shaw. He said, you see dreams and say, why? I dream things that never were and say, why not? So, what's your dream today and where will it take you tomorrow? Thank you very much. Thank you.